I am Satish Prabhu, lecturer EC in Sethu Institute of Technology. What's my name? Satish Prabhu. So you have to pronounce that name correctly. Satish, S-A-D-H-I-S-H. Okay, fine. So okay, today what I'm going to take is the instruction set of 8085. Those who are related to management people, I think this will not be familiar. So even though you have studied. So this is a microprocessor, the base of microprocessor 8085. So this is the base for or the foundation of the microprocessor, which you have now all the dual core processors, Pentium 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So this is the base. Okay, before starting my session, can anyone tell why you want to study instruction set of 8085 processor? What is the reason or why you want to study this? So the first question should be why? So there itself you can have the definition for instruction also. He has told that you are giving a command to whom? To the microprocessor. You are giving the command to the microprocessor. A command, what is a command? You are forcing or saying that you should do this. This is a command. You are forcing it. So you should make sure that your command should be understood by the processor. So not only the command should be understood by the user who is using it, it should be understood by the machine which is going to use it. So what happens if the instruction or the command is not useful? What happens? The processor will not function. It is just like a mind or a brain which is not having any input to it. So you can, if there is no input to the brain, you can say that he is mentally retarded. Isn't it? Okay, so this is the reason why you want to study this instruction set of 8085 processor. So I was talking about processor, microprocessor. So what is a microprocessor? What is a microprocessor? From the name, you don't need to go for technical. From the name, you say what is microprocessor? Microprocessor. Yeah, micro in the sense small. Processor in the sense which is going to perform some operation. A microprocessor. A processor which is going to perform its operation in microseconds. So if you go into technical, they will say that it is a programmable semiconductor logic device which can able to do all the arithmetic and logical operation in a fraction of a second. This is a technical way, it's all that stuff inside. So we will say to the extent that is, this is the processor which is going to do all the process in a fraction of a second. So what kind of process it can do? So that should be the next question. What kind of process? I hope my handwriting is visible to all those people. So what kind of processes can you do? So before that, if you want to know what kind of process it can manipulate, you should know what it can do with the data or the inputs. What should be the inputs given to the processor? So when you are going for any processor kind of thing, you should know it operates only in zeros and ones. What is that? Digits, binary digits. So it is going to operate in digits or binary digits. So if you call 0 and 1, it is bit, binary digit. So you have some families, bits, nibbles, byte, word, double word, you can go like that. So bit in the sense, it is only of 0 and 1. So if it is 0 and 1, you can call it as bit. If it is a nibble, you will have 4 bits, either 111 or 000 or from starting from 00 to any from 111. So if it is a byte, you can have 8 bits. So if it is a word, can you guess? If it is a bit, I told that it is having only 2 bit. If it is a nibble, I am going to say that it is a 4 bit. If it is a byte, I am going to say that it has 8 bits. It is a word, if it is a word, how many bits can it have? Yeah. Okay. One more thing, this 8085 processor is a 8-bit processor. Why? Yeah, it can process only an 8-bit data. Why it can process only 8-bit data?
It can process more than 8-bit data. At that time, it can process only 8-bit
data. Why? Yeah, it is designed. You have an architecture. That architecture details say that you can process only 8-bit at a time. So that your data bus, you have many buses, address buses, data buses, control buses. The data bus or the all the registers inside that architecture of 8085 can handle only 8 bit. So that is why you can call this as an 8 bit processor. And moreover, what are the operation that you can perform in this processor is that you can able to operate only arithmetic and logical operation. You can't do multiplication, division, what you do right now, because this is the base. I have told that this is the base. From this only they have evolved. So you can do multiplication and division also by doing repeated addition, repeated subtraction. Okay, fine. So this is what kind of processors. So I will conclude with this point. That is, this is my last thing. Classification of this instructions according to word size. Classification of these instructions. So you have so many number of instructions. So you should classify these instructions. So you can classify it into three types: 1 byte, 2 byte, and 3 byte. What is that? 1 byte. Come on, 1 byte, 2 byte, and 3 byte. So 1 byte in the sense that instruction will have only the opcode. Opcode in the sense it is called as operational code. So this code is what is what do you call operational code? A general meaning operational code. That is the reverse meaning for operational code. That is, what is operational code? Yeah, it should perform some task. It should perform some task. That is called opcode. And you have one more content that is called operand. What is that? You have came close to the, you should have a task. That task should be applicable to some data, so that only you can have a continuity. So an operation which should have a task, that task should be loaded or should be thrusted onto a data, so that it can able to operate. This is called as a command or an instruction. So altogether you can say that 8085 is an 8 bit processor which can manipulate only ALUs, that is arithmetic logical instructions, and you can able to have the classification like 1 and 2 and 3 byte instruction. I told you all those what is 1 byte, what is 2 byte, what is 3 byte. Oh, okay, 1 byte I told that it will have only opcode. In 2 byte you will have an opcode and an operand, which is of that operand should be only of 8 bit. You have an opcode and you have an operand. An opcode will be of only 1 byte and this operand will be of only 1 byte in the case of 2 byte instruction. In the case of 3 byte instruction, you will have an opcode compulsory. You will have an operational code or an operand. That operand should be of 2 byte or 16 bit. So you have an opcode, you have an operand. So this is 1 byte, this is 2 byte, and this is 3 byte. So you have this classification of instruction according to word size. So you can have a lot of classification. Beyond this, it will take a lot of time. So this is the time limit, 5 minutes. I think I have exceeded 5 minutes. Okay, I will conclude with this. Any more doubts only in these topics? Any doubts?